double aortic arch is a vascular ring that consists of both a right and a left side of the aortic arch that come out of the heart, and then you have one going around each side that meets in the midline and goes on down to the rest of the body. Typically, you only have a left or right, more commonly a left aortic arch, and you don't have the one on the other side. And when you have a double aortic arch, it forms a ring, vascular ring, because it's two vascular structures going around what's the trachea and the esophagus, and that can cause compression and cause effects on the trachea and esophagus, given symptoms such as the respiratory symptoms your child may be having and or the esophageal symptoms.
For a double aortic arch, the surgical treatment usually entails on understanding what else in addition to the double aortic arch is present. First of all, is how much of the airway is compressed, to what degree and what location, and also how much of the esophagus is compressed. It usually is an indication for earlier repair in life. Usually kids that are symptomatic early in life may need an operation when they're either newborns or young children. There are some patients that go on with symptoms that are not as severe or maybe pretty mild, and you do see every now and then a double aortic arch in a teenager or even an adult.
With regards to the treatment for double aortic arch, very frequently it requires surgical intervention. And the reason is you have to remove one of the portions of the vascular ring that's causing the problem. Typically, you take and remove the side of the vascular ring that is the so-called non-dominant, that's simply the smaller side.
And then you have to mobilize the esophagus to make sure it's not compressed by any residual scar tissue or any residual ligaments, and also address the airway. That airway involvement may be as simple as doing nothing other than doing a bronchoscopy to make sure that the release of the ring or division of the ring adequately releases the compression from the airway, or involve something a little more fine-tuned or customized in terms of tracheopexies, in terms of fine sutures that support or expand the lumen or the diameter of the airway so that it doesn't collapse.
So surgery for it can either be one of several methods, and it depends on the exact nature of the double aortic arch. Frequently, we can go in from the side of the chest to go in and remove that segment, and then sometimes do an aortopexy to pexy the blood vessel away so it doesn't recollapse back down, reforming a so-called vascular ring later in life.
Some kids may need maneuvers that may be a little less common. The descending aorta, the blood vessel that takes blood to the rest of the body, may be in a location that may be compressing the airway in and of itself. So when that's the case, sometimes we need to do other procedures that may involve moving that descending aorta, which could be something called an aortic uncrossing or a descending aortic relocation. Those are a little more unique in that they're particularly fine-tuned or customized to address airway compression.
And then on occasion, we'll also go from the right side of the chest, if it's a non-dominant right side of the vascular ring, and we can divide and remove that ring from the right side. So it really is important to understand exactly the type of vascular ring and the structures involved to determine the type of surgery that's needed. It's not a one-size-fits-all